Let's return to our simple Alonzo Muth Mills model of prices within a metropolitan region. Transport costs go up with distance from the city center, and housing costs go down to offset the added cost of commuting. But we're now going to assume that builders can deliver more density. Density just means more housing units on a single acre of space. And we're going to draw a cost curve reflecting the cost of adding more units, and that's going up. Building four stories costs more than building three stories and so forth. We're assuming that people don't care what floor they live on, and all the units are identical. Technically, this curve reflects the marginal cost of each unit, meaning how much the builder's total costs go up as they add one more unit. So we've drawn a cost curve for building, and every building at every location faces a distinct price created by the demand for proximity. So let's draw two lines reflecting the price close to the city center, which is high, and the price far from the city center, which is low. Smart builders will continue building until the point where price equals marginal cost, the intersection of those horizontal lines with the cost curve. That intersection delivers a density for each price, and given that price differs with distance, we get a different density for each distance, which we can add to the original diagram. So the model predicts that as the distance from the city increases, density will fall because the value of space falls, and consequently, builders go for shorter, lower-cost housing. Another way of delivering the same graph is to assume that people buy less land as they move closer into the city because land becomes more expensive. Either way, this model delivers the prediction that as you move farther from the city, you get lower prices, lower density, and longer commutes. The model can also be used to predict whether rich or poor people live closer to the city center. It turns out that there are a couple of effects floating around. Richer people are willing to pay more for shorter commutes, and that pulls them toward the city center because their opportunity cost of time is higher. Richer people also typically want more land, and that pulls them away from the city center where land is cheaper. But I think that the biggest factor explaining why poorer people live closer to the city center in many US cities is access to public transportation. Poorer people are just willing to give up more to have access to a train or a bus, and public transit routes do a pretty good job of explaining where poorer Americans live within metropolitan areas.